shots on goal. A 62-21 advantage for a 41-shot advantage over Welland. Matt Hoare, Mitchell Fitzmaurice, and Austin Brown all with two goals for Caledonia. Corey Pally, the league's leading scorer, with four assists for Caledonia last night in the 7-2 victory. St. Catharines also with a big victory Friday night. A 12-5 victory over the Niagara Falls Canucks. The starting defense for the Corvairs, Chad Bauman and Austin Brown, back for Caledonia. The starting netminder, Mark Sinclair, and the starting forward line of Tyler Hill, the ex-Guelph Storm forward, Blake Luscombe, played with the Ancaster Avalanche last year, and Austin Brown. Brown opposite Owen Green, the Falcons Evans winning the draw. On the left wing is Brandon Viewick. Back for the Falcons is Justin Felker. Caledonia playing it deep on the opening possession. And Broderick Kelly, the right defender for the Falcons. Starting a net for the Falcons is Joel Horajchuk. Quite a goaltending matchup tonight. Sinclair, the number two among goaltending leaders in the nets for Caledonia. Hard shot by Luscombe. Blake Luscombe with the hard first shot on goal down low off to the right-hand side of Horajchuk. 39 seconds in, Luscombe with the game's first shot, and the draw out to the right stick side of Horajchuk. Zottl's shot deflects wide. Dawsey back to the defender, Circoni. Circoni plays it to the left wing. Dawsey taking a hit from Nick Zottl. And two hard hits in the near corner as Matt Hoare taking a hit as well. Jake Brown deflecting to the center red line. Circoni picking it up, moving around Brown. Brown caught way out of position as he tried a tip up on Circoni. And now both teams caught. Quick shot, Horajchuk. A big save down low, close to the goal line. Hoare in tight to the net along with Jake Brown. It was Jake Brown getting the shot away. Caledonia with two hard shots to begin the game. A minute and 26 seconds into period number one. You're watching Corvair Hockey live on ArcProHD.com and Fast Hockey. And we'd like to welcome our radio listeners, our first radio broadcast, radio.profitcorvairs.com. Thanks for joining us as Jake Brown wins the draw, places it in behind the St. Catharines net. Rochford played it up. And Parker brings it up for the Falcons to the Caledonia blue line. Taken away by Rochford. Miffs on the initial pass. Across and played up to center. Jake Brown speedily down the right wing. Stopped up right on the boards. A hard wrist shot by Pauly. Pauly with the 4 points Thursday night in Welland. Tyler Hill, the new addition, also with 3 assists. Saw him in his first game here last Saturday. The 5-1 victory over Fort Erie. Caledonia with a pair of victories last weekend. 5-1 in Ancaster on Saturday night as well. Matt Martin and Cole Hamilton with the 2 Welland goals Thursday night. Mark Sinclair stopping 19 of 21 shots for his 26th victory on the season. Hora Jacek covering up at the right side of his crease. Caledonia moving left to right, wearing their traditional blue uniforms with gold and white trim. The standard muscular bird in the center of the chest, and the Falcons in their traditional white uniforms as well, the red barber pole sleeve, and the Falcon logo in the center of the white uniform with a red trim underneath. James Guest plays it out to the right-hand side. Parker picked off by Maximovic. Fitzmaurice to the side of the right circle. Volpe moves around to the outside. A big hit on the near board by Tanner Allen, the ex Niagara Falls Canuck and Welland Junior Canadians. Again, able to keep it in at the top of the blue line before it's picked up and slapped away. Jack Webb, the long shot down the ice, and icing 2:58 into period number one. Caledonia so far with the advantage in play, several trips hard to the net, and Hora Jacek coming up big early. Sinclair skating to the right circle to play the puck to the red line. It's brought onside by McCartney. Schaefer, the ex-Niagara Ice Dog, to Matt McCartney. McCartney taken out by Broderick Kelly. Fuick moves it around Schaefer, but the pass too far down the right wing board for an icing on the play. In head-to-head matchups, Caledonia doubling up the Falcons the last time they were here on the 19th of December, 4-2 the final. Caledonia with their biggest victory of the season the week before that, 9-2, a 7-goal differential, their biggest in several seasons. Cameron Gray playing 28 minutes of that game after Hora Jacek replaced after 5 goals. McCartney from the blue line takes it hard down the wing himself. The shot, and Austin Brown, the shot and the glove save by Hora Jacek. Face off, well, the linesmen lined up in the neutral zone as McCartney and Vuick have words. They'll leave the draw inside the line. Lushcomb wins it out to his right. The shot down low, Hora Jacek the stop. Bianchi the shot and grabbing the rebound. Lushcomb the shot down hard and low to the ice. I don't believe Sinclair has had a shot on net yet. Caledonia with good opportunities early, but still scoreless on the scoreboard. 0-0, Pro-Fit Corvairs and St. Catharines Falcons. Ratchford the shot through traffic. Three Falcons in front of the net defending. Dawsey plays it to the right wing for Mitchell Webb. Austin Brown going back beside his the left circle inside his own zone. Bianchi over center. Parker with Austin Brown chasing him. Jackson Parker played it to the blue line up to Mitchell Webb, intercepted in the neutral zone by Hill. The drop for Hill, broken up by Cerconi inside the right circle. Langen behind the net to Tyler Hildebrand. Short backhand pass to Diantino. Romeo Diantino, the shot from far out. And Sinclair gloving down his first save of the night. On the inside near post, Sinclair getting out the left hand. Jake Evans plays it to the boards, goes and gets the loose puck, played it up against Jordan Brown. Jake Brown at the end line to the far side of the Falcon net. Swinging around the right wing is Pauly. And it's played back to Jordan Brown, regroups at the blue line, plays it a step over center, whore out to Pauly beside the right circle. Taking a hard hit is Tyler Hildebrand. Bauman moving off the left side of the blue line, and Jake Brown moving in offside as Hoare just off to his right, but Brown a step ahead of the play. Maximovich in the neutral zone. Lushcomb on the left wing. Fitzmaurice taking the shot. Quick shot down the wing, but it went wide. Schaefer the shot. It's blocked, knocked down. Tanner Allen the shoot-in. Zottel knocks him down. And an apparent penalty coming up to Zottel here for interference. Zottel knocked his man down going to the net. And the Falcons to their first power play. Falcons at 15.3% on the power play. Just a bit below halfway in the league. 18th, Broderick Kelly off the draw. The windup, the shot by Jake Evans, and Sinclair hanging on at the far side. This time his second save of the game. 7 seconds into the interference call to Zottel. Ratchford picks it up, plays at the length of the ice, and Horajchuk out to play it in behind his net for St. Catharines. Evans wraps it around the board. Dawsey, the former Cape Breton Screaming Eagle, played in the QMJHL 2 seasons ago. Evans to Kelly. Kelly, the ex-Ice Dog, plays a hard shot off the right shoulder of Sinclair. Kelly again over top the left circle, the shot, and the shot by Evans hit Viewick in the foot. And Caledonia clearing the length of the ice. 101 remaining on the interference call to Zottel. Kelly taking his time to bring it out of his own end. Slides it to Hildebrand. Hildebrand, a hard hit at the left side of center ice by McCartney. McCartney now attempting a vicious hit on the far side. Hildebrand into the corner, Bauman on him. Drops to Pastiglione. Pastiglione, the former All-Star with the Thorold Blackhawks. Felker has it picked off by Sagan. Sagan spending time with the OHL's London Knights. Tanner Allen has his stick checked by Bauman. And Schaefer taking a hard hit in behind the net by Tyler Jackson. Here's a shot by Felker, and it's knocked down on the shot block. Sagan getting his body in front of that, and Felker playing it high out of play into the ceiling. 11:48 to go. Period number one, no score between the Falcons and the Corvairs. Falcons just coming off their first power play of the game. Unsuccessful in power play opportunity number 145. 22 power play goals on the year for the Falcons. Austin Brown across to Zottel. Austin Brown, high blue line, the shot. And it deflects into the near corner. Three Falcons to center. Sircone to the net on the possible 3-on-2. Electing to take the shot as Ty Learn. Learn spending last season with the Kitchener Dutchmen, the Midwest Division leaders. Hill taken out on a hip check sideboard by Sircone, top of the blue line, Bianchi, the turnaround, Austin Brown, and Austin Brown offside as the Caledonia forward line ahead of the play. The icing, or the offside rather, will come back into the neutral zone just in front of the St. Catharines bench. Hoare to Ratchford, Ratchford the long shoot in. Jake Brown grabs it on the corner with a backhand pass in behind the net, looking for Pauly. Play, the Corvairs tried to play it to Ratchford, picked off, brought the other way by Felker, the defender. Brown at center, Hoare down into the corner, goes to get it at the end line. Kelly takes it away from him. Kelly found some open space on Matt Hoare and cleared the puck the distance of the ice. Evans back to Langen. Falcons backed up in their own zone. Felker to center. Vuick the drop on the in behind. Vuick to the net, the shot. Vuick with two chances at the far side of the net. Out in front is Evans. Evans tried a wrap around, now beside the left circle. Cole Langen under the underline. Jordan Brown on Owen Green, played around to the left side of the blue line. Sircone kept it in with a backhand before Ratchford cleared. The icing with 9:31 to go, first period of play. We'll take a break. You're watching Corvair Hockey on arcprohd.com, Fast Hockey, and you're listening on radio.profitcorvairs.com. Welcome back. The shot from the left side of the blue line, Sircone, and Sinclair gloved it down easily. A shot just 3 seconds off the faceoff. Vuick and Jake Evans with two goals in the 12-5 victory last night. Vuick with 6 total points, Evans with 5. Sagan tries a wraparound, knocked off the disc by the defender Sircone. A hard hit on Pastiglione. Sagan goes after him underneath the St. Catharines bench. Zach Lansfield had a hat trick for Niagara Falls. Joel Horajechuk with 27 of 32 saves in the Falcon victory. Adam Dentico stopping 12 of 19 shots for Niagara Falls before being replaced 40 minutes into the game by the Niagara Falls backup goalie Josh Horner. Coming in late was Zottel. Schaefer tries to keep it in left side of the blue line. Caledonia had it pinned down deep, so Zottel able to make a change on the right side of the defense, deep into the shift. Tanner Allen being challenged by Zottel. Zottel, the much bigger of the two. Zottel listed at 6'5", 230 pounds. Broderick Kelly now going over to the linesman to sort out the call. Tyler Jackson apparently going to the box for the Falcons. 8:07 remaining in the period. Caledonia with two wins, a loss, and an overtime loss in the season series. Two more games in St. Catharines before the end of the year between these two rivals. Kelly and Hoare, the last to discuss the penalties. Jackson in the box for the Falcons, as well as Ty Learn, but only the penalty to Learn up and showing. So obviously some kind of a misconduct to Jackson. St. Catharines 2-2 and an overtime loss, but the Falcons now 1 point ahead of the Ancaster Avalanche. Ancaster, 1 win, 3 losses, and an overtime loss in their last 5 games. Hoare, right side of the blue line. Austin Brown plays it to Volpe. Back to Hoare over top the left circle. Side of the net, Brown. Stick checked by Cole Langan. Austin Brown to the right corner. Hoare in the slot and wires a shot from beside the left dot. It goes off the glass and a whistle. 7:36 remaining in the period. Tanner Allen getting the other 2 minutes, not Tyler Jackson. So Allen, for that altercation with Zottel, sits down for 2 minutes. The Corvairs on the 5-on-3 power play. Pauly to take the draw. Brown in the on the left wing. Hoare drops to Austin Brown. Shot down low and off the backboard, just an inch or two wide of the far goalpost. Pauly beside the right circle. Tries to feed it back for Austin Brown. Chipped wisely out of the zone by Dawsey. Dawsey, great play there. Went off on a change. The tip out from the top right side of the blue line. And it's picked up by the Falcons' Felker. And he clears the length of the ice. 44 seconds remaining in the double minor to St. Catharines. Pauly to the right circle, and a whistle, a high stick coming up. Matt Hoare alongside Langan, and Matt Hoare looking around in amazement, not understanding where that penalty's coming from. Lined up against Langan to the left-hand side of the net on the far corner, but Hoare shaking his head in amazement as to the high-sticking call. No score between the St. Catharines Falcons and Caledonia Corvairs. Caledonia just the one loss in regulation all year back on October the 16th to the Falcons. That was the 3-1 loss. Zottel's shot down low goes wide. Schaefer plays it over top the right circle. Luscombe trying to find a man. Finds someone down low underneath the right circle. That was Tyler Hill. But the Falcons managed to get back to full strength. Twice with long clearouts down the far board. Picked up by Dawsey, cross ice feed. Jackson Viewick standing at the blue line. A whistle, the referee Wilmot raised his hand, going over and talking to the scorekeeper. Luscombe to the box for Caledonia. So with the high stick to Hoare and the 2 minutes to Luscombe, the Corvairs two men short for 101. Fitzmaurice chopping away at it. Kelly getting to it first, playing it beyond the end line far corner, just to the right-hand side of Sinclair. And it's picked up and cleared. Bauman, the long pass out underneath the Falcon bench. Kelly right back the other way with the cross ice feed. View it, Kelly now top of the blue line inside the left circle. Sircone back to Kelly. Kelly and Sircone going back and forth, moving up a little bit each time, trying to box in the Corvairs. Bauman and Jordan Brown running around as the Falcons. Several hard passes down low to the ice, but can't get anything generated. The two defenders for Caledonia, despite doing some chasing, managed a long clear down the far board inside their own zone. Zottel into the corner with two Falcons. Jackson now to the net, moves off that action in the corner, and Guest back to the top of the blue line. Pastiglione on his backhand side. Pastiglione back to the corner, back to Guest. Hildebrand in behind the net. Sinclair trying to find enough peripheral vision in behind his right side, a shot. Hildebrand, a step off the end line. Hildebrand still getting a decent shooting lane. Had a good look on the forehand, a step off the far end line. Tipped in, Bianchi in behind his own net. Shovels a no-look backhand pass. This time, McCartney going up the left wing. Quick snapshot. Horajchuk, loose puck. McCartney, two jabs at it. Horajchuk losing it down low in between his pads. McCartney, two shots, and the second from in behind the Falcon net, almost banked it in off the back of Horajchuk's padding. Sircone, Evans far side. Picked off, Caledonia goes in 3-on-2. The shot, the backhand up high and off the glass. Great shift by McCartney. Two shots high, but causing a lot of havoc down around the goal line for Horajchuk. turnover as Hill trying to do too much for Caledonia. Kelly kicks at it with his right foot with Jake Brown coming forward. Jordan Brown, the drop. And with men back for the Falcons, D'Antino clears it to the line. Falker now up the other side. And jumping a hit is Tanner Allen. And Schaefer picks up the loose puck for Caledonia. Pauly to the right circle, the wraparound near side. Caledonia with the advantage early. And the Falcons with some good scoring chances later on in the period off the 5-on-3. Hoare on the high stick. Ratchford inside the line. The Falcons making a change up of their forward lines. And icing with 1:20 remaining in the period. Seven games in the GOJHL tonight. Remember to check www.gojhl.ca. Also fasthockey.com for all the games. Video on demand. Watch all the Greater Ontario Junior Hockey League games at your leisure on Fast Hockey, $22.95 a month. Hoare taking a high stick from Guest. So Hoare, after giving a high stick earlier in the period, gets it back, but obviously not the way they wanted to even things up on the penalty side. Hoare off slowly to the end of the Caledonia bench, and the Corvairs making a full change. 4 minutes on the high stick to Guest. 1:04 remaining in the period as Luscombe taking the draw. Fitzmaurice on the left, Tyler Hill on the right. Hill plays it back to Austin Brown. Brown with it once again off the return to, or from Volpe. Shot by Brown deflects out of play. Luscombe, the long win on the faceoff. But Austin Brown, the puck going back into the neutral zone. Brown was at the top of the blue line on the draw, and the puck on the faceoff win went out to his right-hand side. Falcons clear quickly. 23 seconds remaining in the period. Pass to the wing for Fitzmaurice. Broken up by Langan. Sinclair out to play it. The back pass, Luscombe to the wing, slapped away by Felker. And Sinclair out to play it for the third time in the penalty kill. Caledonia killing 267 penalties, coming home, leading 1-0 over the Thorold Blackhawks in the first. Fort Erie 1-0 over the Welland Junior Canadians. Cambridge at home doubling up the Brampton Bombers 4-2. For all the scores, visit www.gojhl.ca. As Pauly in the opening draw and winning it with a clean backhand is Jake Evans. Falker firing at the length of the ice. Sinclair leaving it for Austin Brown, played over the left wing beside the circle. Hard to the net, a fallen Corvair sandwiched in between Langan. It was Brown hard to the net, but he was hit as he went with speed to the far corner of the net, knocked the net off the mooring. Evans and Langen back for the Falcons. Still 2:36 remaining in the carryover penalty from period number one. And now Jake Brown going off for 2 minutes. Interesting penalty, likely goaltender interference. Brown simply hard to the net off the long pass far side board. Brown with the big reach out to try a tip and goes to the penalty box for 2 minutes. As a result, play to center. Zottel, the bouncing puck for Pauly, and the icing on the play. Pauly with 22 goals, 66 assists for 88 points to lead the league. Adam Kowalik, 77 points in the number two spot. Must be 87 points. I'll have to double check that when I get a chance as Sinclair covers up. No, I have Kowalik at 31 goals and 46 assists for 77 points. Kowalik with a game in hand. At one point a week or so ago, Kowalik with a 1 or 2 point lead. Shot at the side of the net. Hill, the hard shot. The fluttering shot, they score! Jordan Brown, the misplay by Hora Jachuk. First the shot down low at the side of the net. Hora Jachuk made the big left pad save. And then as he came off that near corner, Hora Jachuk with not enough time to get to the Jordan Brown shot on the far side. Here's another shot, Maximovic hard to the net. Hill credited with the goal. So two tips, Luskum with the tip also. Luskum with the shot down low at the near side of the net. Jackson plays it in, it bounces off the end boards. He gathers in his own rebound before he's hit hard by Bauman. Kelly Fitzmaurice looking on, plays it to the other side for Sircone before he gets it back. Sircone tips it to the red line. Jake Evans picks it up. Bauman hits him, and it squirts free to Fitzmaurice, gathering speed now in the neutral zone. Hits center. Pastiglione tries to take him out with a knee-on-knee check. Fitzmaurice and Pastiglione collide at the Caledonia blue line. So they were 4-on-4 with 24 seconds remaining on the penalty to Jake Brown. And now the knee-on-knee hit, Pastiglione will sit down for 2 minutes. The Corvairs will have a 36-second two-man advantage when Jake Brown gets out of the box. Pauly to Austin Brown. Pauly has a look. Plays it back to Brown. Pauly, the shot, it hits the end board and goes hard out the far side. Hoare to Austin Brown. The two crossover back to Austin Brown. The shot down low off the right side of Felker. Pauly, side of the net. mishandles for a second, has to go out the far side, played the second opportunity in behind the net, shot hard down low by Austin Brown. Pauly crosses to the other side. Austin Brown, a good long look, over to the circle, the shot, it's chopped down, Hoare hard to the net, and it's deflected wide by Hill. Hill, a fifth round choice in 2011 by the Ottawa 67s, ninth overall, played his first home game here last Saturday, the 5-1 victory over Fort Erie. Believe he had a couple goals as well. Face off Evans and Hill. Hill wins the draw clean to Hoare across to Brown, and his shot wide and out the far side. Hill's goal last week on the power play at 13-17 also had the opening goal last week. Hill drawing an assist on Caledonia's second goal. The power play marker by Volpe last week. Shot by Pauly, wide and out of play, out to the right of Hora Jaychuk. Luscombe, Fitzmaurice, and Volpe. Volpe now going to the left wing on the draw. Luscombe wins it back to Schaefer. Shot by Zottel. And Zottel from outside tries to go in between the pads down low of Hora Jaychuk. 31 seconds remaining on the knee-on-knee hit. Pastiglione serving that one. Zottel across to Schaefer, back to Zottel. Luscombe over the circle, drops for Zottel, and the shot hit the outside of the near post. Zottel gloved down by Langen, plays the long pass around the board. Schaefer up to the side half wall, and it's chipped off the bottom of the board. The bank passing out by Mitchell Webb. Fitzmaurice, the backhander, looking for Luscombe in the slot. Picked off by Felker, played to the left side of the blue line. And Viewick plays it out. Zottel back for Caledonia, up to the far side of the blue line where Luscombe picks it up. Volpe, a hard upper body check on the defender Felker, or Guest rather, and the shot from the left side by Zottel deflects out of play. 8 games in the GOJHL tomorrow. Caledonia with a 19-point lead over St. Catharines in the standings. Ancaster 1 point back of St. Catharines in the number 3 spot. To put that in perspective, Caledonia with a little over a 9-game lead over St. Catharines in the standings with their 32-1-1-2 record. A 49-game regular season. Caledonia 18-0-0-1 at home. The shot by Punkery, played away by Parker. Punkery the second time, rings it around the boards from the far outside. Ratchford down underneath the right circle, shot by Luscombe, goes along the end line. Catching a piece of it is Hora Jaychuk. Second shot from outside by Ratchford. Hora Jaychuk, 2 saves in succession. McCartney to the red line, 1-on-1, turns into a 2-on-1. Shot by Punkery, the third shot. A 2-on-1. Punkery took the shot. Initially, it was the Corvair on the right side going 1-on-1. And then the rebound went right into the high slot, actually resulting in the 3-on-1. So two big stops by Hora Jachuk. Brown ahead to Maximovich down low. And Hora Jachuk down to his knees at the top of the crease to make the save. These two teams met 2 years ago in the Sutherland Cup final. The Game 7 win, the first championship for the Corvairs, first of two. Matt Quilty with the game-winning goal, the first Sutherland Cup championship in the history of the Caledonia Corvairs. Caledonia winning it again last year in LaSalle in six games. Back-to-back champions looking to become the first team to ever three-peat. Volpe plays it to the neutral zone. Langan chops it off the underside of the board. Jordan Brown back for Caledonia. Tanner Allen a hard forecheck, but Brown plays it to the far side. Bauman into the corner. Long shoot in, Hora Jachuk out to play it. Schaefer at his own blue line, up to Pauly, backhands it in. Langan, Brown lifts the stick just slightly, but just enough for Brown to create a scoring chance. Brown now with the puck pinned in deep in behind the Falcon net. The only goal, the Tyler Hill goal, the fluttering shot. First it was Luscombe at the side of the net with a hard shot. Hill with a rebound, and before Hora Jachuk could change his sense of direction to the far corner, Hill put it in the top of the net, 1-0 Corvairs. Pauly tripped up, no call on Langan. Langan with the stick heavy in the feet of Pauly, but no call on the play. Brown along with Hoare, two players for the Falcons in behind the net. Hoare with a cross check on Evans. No call as the Falcon fans in the building not happy with the call. Shot from outside by Owen Green. Viewick the turnaround. Jake Brown's side of the net. Plays it for Schaefer. Schaefer still on the Niagara Ice Dogs active roster. Chips it in beyond D'Antino. D'Antino to Viewick, and Viewick the shot high over top the net. D'Antino and Viewick with Ratchford the only man back for Caledonia created their own 2-on-1 with speed off both sides of the wing. Pastiglione chops it in. No icing on the call, so Sinclair out to play it. Wraps it around the far side board, and the hard shoot-in by Broderick Kelly. Sinclair with a save on the far-out shot directed it to the near corner Caledonia end. Play back the other way. Hill hard on Felker. Felker the turnaround. Mitchell Webb across to Hildebrand on the backhand side of Ratchford, who plays it up to the neutral zone. Ratchford with the interception and back up to center. And Ratchford had his head down on the pass, took a hard hit from Pastiglione, and a slight ding toward the net. Hill may have slightly grazed the inside of the post near side. Tyler Jackson going underneath him to the body of Sagan. Sagan went low. on the hit. Caledonia bringing it out to center. Punkery in behind the net. Swings around his man, centers the pass for McCartney. McCartney throwing a hit on Jackson Parker, the shot from Bauman into the corner. Under 10 minutes to go. Second period, no scoring in the first. Caledonia with the edge in shots, 12-10. And Tyler Hill from Luscombe and Jordan Brown opened the scoring early in this period. Brown with the shot over the right shoulder of Hora Jaychuk. Hora Jaychuk out of the Sudbury Minor Hockey System. Face off deep Caledonia zone. This game brought to you by ARC Pro HD Video Productions, 519-755-7409. You're watching live on arcprohd.com, Fast Hockey, and listening live on radio.profitcorvairs.com as Mitchell Webb and Quentin Maximovich to take the draw. Maximovich playing two games with the Erie Otters this season, 100 total games. More of a grinder was Maximovich in his OHL time. Just 12 points in three seasons for Maximovich. Mitchell Webb, Hildebrand in front of the net. Pastiglione beside the Caledonia left circle, drops for James Guest. Pastiglione at the dot, in deep for Hildebrand, and the shot by Hildebrand on the forehand goes long and out of play. Caledonia now making a full change of the penalty kill. Daniel Volpe in the box for Caledonia, a minute 30 seconds remaining in his penalty. Faceoff coming out to the neutral zone. Evans, Dawsey, and the right winger, Viewick, the forward power play unit for the Falcons. The Falcons giving the Corvairs their only regulation loss on the year. Caledonia 10-0 their last 10 games. And that last regulation loss way back on October the 16th in St. Catharines, the 3-1 loss. Hard hit in behind the Falcon net. Jake Evans back into the play slowly, so they go 4-on-4. Evans now at the left circle, drop to the top of the blue line. Evans into Dawsey, and Dawsey a step into the end line. Evans takes a spear at the top of the Caledonia crease. Sagan not happy with Evans being in so close to Sinclair. Evans takes a spear to the chest. A stoppage in play, 7:45 to go. Second period of play, a tight one between the Falcons and Corvairs. The last two meetings between these teams. Caledonia with a 4-2 victory on December the 19th. A week prior to that, the 9-2 blowout shot and down low, Sinclair making the save. Shot from along the end line out the far side by Tyler Jackson. Guess to Pastiglione. Back to Guest. Guest moves to the top of the blue line. Forehand shot. Hildebrand Pastiglione moves in off the left side. Stepped into it as he got three strides, full strides in from the left side of the blue line. And the shot by Guest right at the right dot, Caledonia zone. And Sinclair with another big save. 7:07 remaining in the period. St. Catharines with a late change, so Falker has to stay on. Ty Learn out to the left wing. Spent some time with the Kitchener Dutchmen, the Midwest Division leaders. Caledonia, of course, leading the Golden Horseshoe. Leamington, the leaders in the West. Shot and they score! Austin Brown on the beautiful backhand, back pass by Tyler Hill. Austin Brown with his second point of the evening at 6:47. The hard shot inside the right circle. Hora Jaychuk could not get far enough across to the left or the right near side post. His left, right from our broadcast vantage point. 6:47 remaining. Austin Brown with his first goal tonight. Excuse me, Jordan Brown with the second assist on the Tyler Hill. So Hill with his second point. Great no-look back pass. 13:13, the official time of the goal. Langen plays it around the far side of the blue line, cleared the rest of the way by Owen Green. An icing 6 minutes to go in the period as both teams make a full change. We'll take a break. You're watching Corvair Hockey on ArcProHD.com Fast Hockey and listening on radio.profitcorvairs.com. Back to the action, cross ice feed. Fitzmaurice trying to receive the pass. Stepping in between was Guest. Caledonia able to bring it back the other way. End-to-end rushes both sides now as it's picked up and shot wide by Jackson. Volpe cross ice to the left wing this time. And Caledonia with two long passes on this shift. Pastiglione, Fitzmaurice spent time with the Niagara Ice Dogs. Fitzmaurice into the slot, picked off by Parker. James Guest picks it up behind his own net. The drop for Romeo Diantino plays it to the Caledonia blue line. Ratchford, long pass to the top of the blue line, cleared out by Punkery. And into the corner goes Falker along with Bauman. Bauman gets enough of it to get it to the half wall near side. McCartney, the sharp backhand, and Ratchford unable to keep it in for Caledonia. Ratchford to Bianchi. Bianchi clears it in off the bottom of the board in behind the St. Catharines net. Zottel the shot wide, and it's picked up and cleared by Tanner Allen. Play to the line. Allen once again, the shoot-in, and it's deflected wide by Jack Webb. He goes off on a change. Webb, 48 games played last year with the Saginaw Spirit, registering one goal. Felker back, 3:28 in the period. Goals in the period by Tyler Hill. Tyler Hill's got to be looking at first star right now so far with a goal and an assist. The setup probably even nicer than the goal. Found Brown on the near side with the no-look backhand pass. Another shot by Hill down low. And Horajczyk this time out to challenge, angled to the right-hand side to the top of the crease. He hangs on, 3:01 remaining in the period. Caledonia, their 37th team game tonight, so 12 more games for Caledonia. As mentioned earlier, they've got a 9-game and 1-point lead in the standings, 19 points over the second place Falcons. So within 3 games or so of clinching the division, any combination of likely 3 Caledonia wins and 3 Falcon losses, or perhaps Avalanche losses, a point behind them, shot by Luscombe, and the Corvairs will be 4-time division champions, 4-time defending division champions. Played in year 1 in the Midwest Division, won the division before losing out in the division semifinal in 6 games to the Stratford Culletons. Hill works his way into the slot, the hard shot down low. Jake Brown looking for a deflection. Tyler Hill with the last 2 excellent scoring chances for Caledonia. Hill could have easily had 2 more on the last 2 shots. Under 2 minutes to go now. Second period of play. Puck out of play, just a couple people over from me. Too bad, could have caught myself a puck. Haven't managed to do that yet in my 4 years. Have to multitask, catch a puck and broadcast at the same time. Brown with Pauly on the right wing, won it clean to Pauly, shot by Zottel off the back of the board. Brown into the corner to Ratchford. Ratchford right side of the defense, inbound feed and picked off by Justin Felker. Broderick Kelly tries to make his way to the inside of the much bigger Zottel. This time on the near corner, Learn and Zottel. Learn goes into the near corner to make a hit on Matt Hoare. Brown deflects it away. A bad play there by Pastiglione. Lost the puck to Brown and then in frustration knocked him down to the right-hand side of the net, Pastiglione. And now lots of pushing and shoving down below the end line after the initial confrontation. So Pastiglione may go down for a cross-check on Brown. Will likely sit for 2 minutes, and then all the stuff after the whistle. Zottel nailing Pastiglione. down under the end line. So he'll go to the box. Pauly some pushing and shoving after that as well. He'll go to the dressing room. Caledonia leading the conference in penalties. Caledonia with 1,345 minutes in penalties. Saw a player interview to Daniel Volpe, actually right on the main portion of the Caledonia website. And even Volpe was mentioning the Corvairs need discipline as the playoffs approach. Leading the conference in penalty minutes, just the one regulation loss on the year, but the penalties may catch up with them as the playoffs hit. The Falcons and Avalanche, two of the speedier teams in the conference, and should they get that far, the Kitchener Dutchmen, a lot of speed on that team. I see them once in a while play on Thursday nights. Kelly and McCartney, a long delay here, so we'll take a short break. This game brought to you by Arc Pro HD Video Productions. Visit them at www.arcprohd.com. You're watching live on arcprohd.com and on Fast Hockey and listening on radio.profitcorvairs.com. Brown now skating off to the Caledonia penalty box. He was in the first altercation with Pastiglione and slams the penalty box door in frustration. Just the 2 minutes to Zottel showing up on the scoreboard. Eight games in the NHL tonight. Check www.nhl.com. And a reminder, please check the GOJHL main website, www.gojhl.com, for all your up-to-the-minute scores. Scores refresh every 120 seconds. Offside as Dawsey down hard, angled just down the right circle. Faceoff will come back to the neutral zone. Evans, Dawsey, and Viewick, the power play unit for the Falcons. Maximovic, Jordan Brown up on the right wing. And Mitchell Fitzmaurice to the left of Maximovic. And Bauman, the lone man back on defense for Caledonia. Brown will drop back after the faceoff. Zottel now to the room. He'll get a misconduct. Too many words to say about the previous penalty. And Zottel now back to the room for Caledonia. Dawsey tries to glove it down. Here's the calls now. So Zircone around the boards. Evans, top of the left circle. The shot, Dawsey scores. Dawsey wide open underneath the left circle on the feed from Buick. And with just 9.6 seconds remaining in the period, the Falcons break the Corvairs shutout. Sinclair looking for his sixth shutout, but not tonight. He'll stay tied with Hora Jaychuk for the league lead with five on the year. We'll double check that as well. We've got the goaltending leaders here. Final draw of the period. McCartney against the defender. Felker trying to break his stick free. Shot by Bianchi, close to the buzzer already going. Hora Jaychuk taking no chances. No scoring in the first period. Dawsey with just 9.6 seconds remaining on the power play. Here's the announcement here. It was Nick Dawsey from Brandon Buick and Ty Learn with just 9.6 seconds remaining in the period to cut the Caledonia lead in half. Time now for the out-of-town scoreboard. Welland with a 2-1 lead over the Fort Erie Meteors. That game in the third period. Listowel 2-0 over Guelph, so Listowel trying to jump over Guelph in the Midwest Conference. Listowel just a point back. Ancaster 2-1 over Thorold. Opening draw, Luscombe wins it back to Bauman. Jordan Brown plays it deep. Hora Jaychuk out to throw it around the far circle. Picked up by Allen. Possible turnover. Hill going into the corner. Jordan Brown tries to glove it down. It goes the length of the ice where it's picked up by Bauman. Bauman, the long feed out for Hill. Too far for him. It's picked up by Jackson Parker. For all the out-of-town scores, please visit www.gojhl.ca. Shot by Brown. Hora Jaychuk getting a piece of it. Shot by Jordan Brown up over top the net. Luscombe, the feed into the right circle, bouncing puck for Jordan Brown. And it's picked up, played by Mitchell Webb out to the other side of the red line. Corvairs play it right back in. 2-on-2 as Pastiglione late getting back on a change. The sharp backhand shot by Hill. Have to give Hill the first star of the game if it were my pick as of now. Hill a goal and an assist. Luscombe and Jordan Brown assisting on the game's opening goal. No goals scored till the just under the midway point of the second period. Brown to the right wing, the shot by Hoare goes wide off the board. Schaefer plays it up, tried to find Hoare along the half wall. Pastiglione to the red line, and from the far side plays it into the near corner Caledonia zone. Shoot in by Hildebrand. Teams once again, Caledonia moving left to right, and St. Catharines moving from right to left. Caledonia in their blue uniforms, St. Catharines in their white. That's if you're listening to the radio broadcast, radio.profitcorvairs.com. You may also be watching live on arcprohd.com or Fast Hockey. Thank you for joining us. The shot from far out. And Sinclair down to his knees to make the save. Eight games tonight in the NHL. Boston and Toronto tied at two. Montreal in St. Louis, both those games at two, both after following two periods of play. The Buffalo Sabres up 4-0 on the Washington Capitals. Eight games total in the NHL tonight. Check www.nhl.com. Guest turns it over, Luscombe to the wing. And it's played up and out by Jake Evans. Bianchi rings it around the wall. Horajchuk comes far out of his net. And Bianchi and Evans jabbing away at each other. Evans to the box for the jab on Bianchi. I must confess, I didn't see it. The altercation in behind the play was looking at Horajchuk out to play the puck in behind his own net. Hor with Brown on the left wing, Hill on the right, wins it clean back to Austin Brown. Hill the backhander for Hor's side of the net. Austin Brown, the shot deflects off Dazzy in behind the net. Falker picks it up, clears it to the line but not out. Shot by Volpe. Hor the deflection in tight. Check www.gojhl.ca. Sometimes our Wi-Fi's a little slow here. You can get all the updated penalty calls. Sometimes we miss one or two. Evans in the box for another 1:29. Hor to the sidewall. And a reminder, you can watch every game, home or away, for the Corvairs or any team in the league. Fast Hockey, fasthockey.com, $22.95 a month. Brown in the slot, fires a hard shot low. Hor on the corner, plays it instead to Hill on the far side. Volpe on the near corner under the left circle, cannot glove it down, and it's picked up and cleared by Cole Langan. Hill stopped up by the defender, got enough of his body behind him. Hill got enough of the right side of his body around Langan that he was able to get beyond the hit and head straight toward the net. Maximovic to the red line, the shot, it deflects off the blocker of Horajchuk. Picked up, clear to the line, Allen clear to the line, and Ratchford got an open lane to shoot. Because Allen was still back on the attempted clear out. Ratchford taking advantage. Horajchuk, another save. The much busier of the two goalies following the flurry of shots by Caledonia in the second period. Maximovic to Ratchford. Ratchford wraps it off the board. Picking up the rebound at the right circle was Jordan Brown. And Cerconi now for the Falcons. The wise clear out, the icing deep down the far wall. This game brought to you by Arc Pro HD Incorporated, high definition video production. Visit them at www.arcprohd.com. Switch sides on the draw this time. This time off to the left glove side of Horajchuk. One cleanly by Caledonia and a big glove save by Bauman. Shot may have been going wide. Horajchuk taking no chances on the hard shot halfway up by Bauman. Angled out the far corner. Head-to-head, Caledonia, two wins, a loss, and an overtime loss, I believe, on the season series. We'll double-check that. The two wins coming on the 12th and 19th of December. The overtime loss, the overtime win, excuse me, Caledonia 1-1-0. Horajczyk the save out the far side. So Caledonia, three wins and an overtime loss. St. Catharines, one win, two losses, and an overtime loss. There's where the confusion comes in. When you get the games going to overtime and head-to-head matchups, it leaves a different result for both sides in terms of the head-to-head based on the fact that the games go to overtime. Shot by Kelly, deflects off Sagan. A high arcing shot over the net as a result. So Caledonia, if they can hang on to their one goal lead tonight, likely to move to within a couple of games of clinching the division. Kelly plays it in. Ratchford to Fitzmaurice, neutral zone. Chopped away by Owen Green. Ratchford to the red line. Falker to the other side of the neutral zone. This time for Green up in the corner. It's played around the board by Bianchi. Evans on him. And Bianchi and Evans still coming together deep in the zone. In fact, both of them out of the play as the Corvairs came up ice. Stretching is Jordan Brown, the St. Catharines faithful, claiming he was offside. Brown now back. Vuick, the lone man, up to forecheck. Allen, the inbound feed off the wall. Vuick picks it up in behind the net. Shot by Guest. He fans on it. Hoare takes it away. Up to Hill with Luscombe streaking to the net. Deflection by Luscombe. Allen from the red line, one on two, but a man behind him. That's Jack Webb. Picked up and cleared to the center ice red line. Kelly to the left and cleared in by Falker. Bauman on Tanner Allen, and Bauman's gonna get a interference call here. Now, Jake Brown coming to the defense of Bauman. Simply a hard upper body hit by Bauman, and they're calling interference on the near wall on the hit underneath the Caledonia bench. Bauman not happy with it at all. 12-10 remaining. The Falcons looking to tie the game on the power play. The first power play goal of the game, the Nick Dawsey goal at 9:51. 9.6 seconds remaining in the period. Picked up and cleared by Maximovich. Dawsey from the red line, Vuick to the net. A big hit by Fitzmaurice on Dawsey coming from in behind the Caledonia net. Shot by Kelly, rebound, Vuick and Sircone with shots. Sircone with the second shot. Viewick in tight to the net, looking to grab a rebound. And Sinclair, good vision to bring it in with the left glove. Hildebrand and McCartney on the draw. Tyler Hildebrand wins the draw. Tyler Jackson to the end line. Back to Felker now, right side. Hildebrand in tight, shot by Jackson. High rebound. Jackson tried a second shot. Had it gone in, it may have been above the crossbar. Bianchi clearing down the near side. Falcons regrouping quickly. Cross ice feed, Hildebrand. Bianchi takes him out of the play. The September and October Defender of the Month. Also saw Bianchi in the Prospects game, although he was the only one to dress for Caledonia. Matt Rymack, an alternate. Shot up and around the corner by Hildebrand. And Caledonia gaining possession on the near board, clearing the rest of the way. Guest in behind his net for the Falcons. Passes out to his left for Evans, and Ratchford throws him to the ice. Ratchford, a big hit, and Evans getting up slow. The Corvairs killing the interference call to Bauman. Bauman off immediately, and Caledonia back to full strength. Dawsey Viewick to the net, the deflection, and it's wide on the corner. Hill ahead to Matt Hoare. Matt Hoare with the shot. The former Oshawa General. A hard shot to the underside of Horajacek's left hand. Horajacek, a huge save down low at the far corner. Draw one by Jake Brown. Hoare slides it back to the right. Batting it down is Broderick Kelly. Schaefer, the shot, they score! The quick shot by Schaefer, and Matt Hoare gets the stick down at the side of the net. Hoare may have touched it in midair. Good hand-eye coordination by Matt Hoare. A couple of inches off the ice, and Hoare tapped it in at the far corner. Matt Hoare with 9:34 remaining, the 10:26 mark, and Caledonia restores their two-goal lead. Matt Hoare with his 31st goal of the season. Bauman takes out Mitchell Webb. Hill and Brown the assists. Tyler Hill with his second assist. Hill from the left corner of the blue line. Spotted Hoare on the far corner. And icing with 8:53 remaining. Caledonia with two more games in St. Catharines. Friday, February the 5th, and Friday, February the 26th. Caledonia next in action tomorrow night, 7 p.m. at Welland Arena, to face the Junior Canadians in Niagara Falls at the Gale Center Friday night, 7:30, against the Niagara Falls Canucks. And then they'll face, shot by Green, Evans there as well. Green down to his knees, and the shot went wide to the far side. Cross ice feed up for Dawsey, the tap in. Dawsey to the net, the shot, and they score. The quick poke in by Brandon Buick, and the goal disallowed immediately. I noticed that because head coach Mike Bullard had his hands out. Here's the announcement. Goal by Buick kicked in at the far corner. So that one won't count. The Corvairs remain in the 3-1 lead. Punkery wins the draw, cleanly back to Sagan. Rochford to center, Langan on the other side of the red line, plays it up for Dawsey, and taken away by a back-checking Ryan Punkery. Rochford around the far outside, up for Punkery at the blue line. Langan plays it to the red line. The shootout by Langan, Punkery able to snap it away and go down the far side. McCartney the shot wide of the net. And Sircone the last to touch as the whistle goes with 7:29 remaining. St. Catharines in action tomorrow as well, a 3 o'clock game in Niagara Falls. Back home Friday night against the Fort Erie Meteors. On the road next Saturday in Thorold, and the following Tuesday, the 26th of January, they're in Pelham, shot by Pauly. And Horajchuk, the save at the top of the crease on his knees. Caledonia looking to go 4-1 on the season series. The shot, Brown the deflection, far side of the net. Horajchuk got a piece of it with his left pad down low. Pauly avoids the check moving forward, forced to the outside on the hit by Felker. Pauly fell into the boards, got up immediately. Brown the shot, Pauly to the net, snapped away by the Falcon defender. Felker played it to the near side wall. The Falcons chip it in the rest of the way and change up their forward lines. Dawsey and Evans now out for the Falcons. Hoare's got it pinned deep down on the near wall, in behind the net for Brown, out the far side, back to Brown. Hoare to the front of the net, but the pass by Brown picked up by Dawsey. Evans, the long pass back into his own zone. So Caledonia with two games on the road, tomorrow in Welland, Friday in Niagara Falls, before coming back home next Saturday to face the Welland Junior Canadians. Welland really slipping as of late, now all the way back in the seventh spot. Would have to face St. Catharines in the first round. That's if the playoffs were to start today. Tied with Thorold with 32 points are the Canadians. Pelham, the first round opponent for the Corvairs. That pretty much set with the Panthers with just one win on the year. Turnaround shot by Hill. On the corner, Fitzmaurice to the end line. Hill once again. Hill, a goal and two assists tonight. Hill on the near corner on the long pass from Schaefer, shot by Fitzmaurice, blocked by the defense, Jackson back for the Falcons, and he made the block. Viewick now backed up on the Fitzmaurice forecheck. Fitzmaurice got three men all bunched in and actually did a good job of forechecking all three of them, almost forced a turnover. Had a bit of a confrontation with Viewick. A stick swinging with Viewick, but the stick not connecting. Punkery down the left wing. McCartney, the quick shot. Ratchford went to the net off the right side of the blue line. Got a good chance in the slot, but unable to connect with a pass. Under five to go, 3-1 Corvairs. No scoring in the first. The high fluttering shot over the right shoulder of Hora Jaychuk by Tyler Hill in the second period. Luscombe and Jordan Brown assisting. Then Austin Brown from Tyler Hill and Luscombe, the 13-13 mark. The shot by Brown at the near corner of the net on the behind the back pass by Hill. 2-0 Corvairs, then the power play goal by Nick Dawsey. Sinclair plays it to the side wall, a stoppage in play. A slash with 3:27 remaining. Dawsey cut the lead on the power play. The wide open shot underneath the left circle. And then Matt Hoare, Tyler Hill spotted him back door out the far corner. Hoare batted it out of the air 2 inches off the ice at the 10:26 mark. 3-1 Corvairs with 3:23 to go. A minute and 55 seconds remaining on the penalty to Mitchell Fitzmaurice. Shot by Kelly off the outside of Maximovic. Cercone mishandles. Maximovic one-on-one with him. Mishandled the puck over the Falcon blue line. Never did get a shot away with Volpe behind him. And now Volpe, a hard hit up high on the right side of Brandon Cercone. The long dump in by Bianchi. This game brought to you by Arc Pro HD Incorporated. High definition video production. Visit them at www.arcprohd.com. Thanks for joining us on our initial radio broadcast, radio.profitcorvairs.com. And thanks as always for joining us live on arcprohd.com and Fast Hockey. All games live or in demand. See all the GOJHL games at your leisure. www.fasthockey.com. A whistle with exactly 2 minutes to go. Caledonia, should they hang on, will be a full 21 points ahead of the second place Falcons. Be sure to take a look at the Ancaster score. At last check, 2-1 over Thorold at Morgan Firestone Arena. Ancaster a point back of the Falcons. Hildebrand tries to keep it in at the blue line, but an offside on the play. Caledonia just a couple games now from clinching the division championship. Caledonia, three-time defending division champions, two-time defending Sutherland Cup champions and looking to become the first team to three-peat the Sutherland Cup this year. A timeout being called here. The horn going to signify the final timeout of the evening. Sinclair back to the net, looking for his 27th victory on the season. Against three losses and a tie. So Sinclair, empty net now for the Falcons, a sixth attacker on. Evans, Dawsey, Hildebrand, and Viewick, the four forwards on. Sircone and Kelly, the two defenders back, as a sixth attacker now on for the Falcons. Shot by Viewick. Save made down low off the pads. Here's a chance at the empty net. Fitzmaurice scores! Mitchell Fitzmaurice with his 15th goal of the year into the empty net, seals it for the Corvairs. A 4-1 lead with a minute and 14 seconds remaining. Two games remaining in the regular season series against the Falcons. The Corvairs move to 3-1 on the year against the Falcons. And the Falcons drop to 1-3-1 overtime loss. Viewick just tossed from the game. Brandon Viewick, a misconduct with a little over a minute to go in the third period. Pauly to take the face off. Jake Brown on the wing opposite Tanner Allen. Matt Hoare on the far wing. Hildebrand opposite him. Parker and Felker now with it. Back on defense for St. Catharines. Felker plays it out of play on the far board. Two goals in the third. Matt Hoare at 10:26. And Fitzmaurice into the empty net. Played up to the blue line. Pauly chips it in. Felker, Hoare on him. Hoare snows the corner, but Felker already left. Jack Webb playing it in behind the Corvair net. And just killing some time is Zottel now. He throws it the length of the ice. Caledonia in action tomorrow. You can catch that on fasthockey.com. Hoare to the red line. Felker, a hard bank pass off the board, picked up by the Caledonia defender, Ratchford. Pauly through neutral ice. Pauly with speed around the corner of the shot. And what a final save by Hora Jachuk at the buzzer. A huge save by Hora Jachuk on Pauly. And now the Falcons having some more words, not appreciating that final rush by Pauly with under 5 seconds to go. They have words with him about it, but now Pauly going and congratulating Mark Sinclair on his 27th victory of the season. The Corvairs salute the crowd following their 4-1 victory for the Caledonia Corvairs Hockey Club. I'm John Molson. Tonight's final score, the Corvairs win it by a final of 4-1 over the St. Catharines Falcons. A reminder, go to the GOJHL website, www.gojhl.ca, to review the scoring. The next two Corvair games are on the road tomorrow night in Welland and Friday.